In my experiment last winter determining if it mattered whether using fresh or older milk in making yogurt, one of the things I did was, depending on which batch I was making, I heated it to different temperatures, kind of a what I would consider a base pasteurization temperature of like 165 or so, kind of the 161 for 1 minute, but we often heat just more and then just turn it off. It gets about the same, or up to 181. What I found and have continued to find over the last year of doing this is that, without a detailed experiment, is that when I heated it to 181 degrees Fahrenheit, it resulted in a much more solid yogurt as opposed to a little bit of a looser yogurt at the lower temperature. Well, my initial kind of assumption was that there's a difference in how the pasteurization like worked, in that like kind of heating at the higher temperature creates better pasteurization, and that might well be true. But I also think there's a possibility that there's other stuff going on, such as kind of what I'm trying to determine here is when you heat it to a higher temperature and then let it cool, as we do out in the open air, it would then result in like more evaporation. So there'd be less water in there and like more of the solids, I would say. And while I don't think there's a massive difference, I've also noticed that sometimes when I let it cool too much and then heat it back up again, it results in a more solid yogurt. So today what I'm doing is just trying to determine how much water evaporation actually occurs when I heat these to the different temperatures. So we're getting close here. We're at like 157 degrees Fahrenheit on this one. And I don't know why we chose 181. That was just a temperature that I think at some point my mom set into this thermometer, and so we started using it. It's not like we had a real good reason that that's... Oh, there. We're at 165 on that one. Now this one I'm going to heat up to 181. Before then... letting them cool down to about 113 is what I've been using. We've always said between 110 and 115, but I've actually been getting it to 113 pretty regularly. You can see there isn't like a... And this isn't even a perfect example because we generally make a whole half gallon of yogurt at a time in a single pot as opposed to a... That got up to... Highest temperature there was 182, but that's just kind of typical. So this maybe isn't a great example, but it is the same setup I was using last year, and I don't want to make a full gallon of yogurt at a time. And it allows me to do it separately because I have these two nearly identical pots. I'm cleaning these really well just so that there isn't kind of any difference in them, because I put the yogurt or the milk in them previously, but some kind of non-filmed experiments I was doing earlier this year was actually doing this where I would use one of these to measure out the milk, and then the other one would stay clean and I actually wouldn't clean it out, and I didn't see any difference between kind of the one that after having milk in it, letting that sit while the yogurt was being heated up and cooled down, and then putting milk into one and not milk into the other. I didn't really see any difference I was able to clearly notice between them. And the only thing was maybe a tiny bit of flavor, which is another reason why I suspect that this may not be due to difference in pasteurization. And this is now down to 113 on the one I only heated up to 65 degrees.
That is 870, 34. Then goes into the cooler with the 181 degree one now down to 113. Have 860 grams.
With some assumptions for the amount lost in transfers, a total of 9 grams from some measurements I did on other batches, the 181 degree evaporated 52 grams and the 165 evaporated 39 grams. A 13 gram or 1.4% difference.
That doesn't seem like enough that it really will cause the difference. So despite some previous indications that maybe this is what's causing the difference between them, just looking at these numbers, I'm doubtful, but I'll have to see how these work in the end result.
After 10 hours in the cooler and overnight in the fridge, these are ready to kind of, I want to see how they did. So starting with the 181, this is, yeah, pretty solid as I consider things. Going to the 165, yeah, you see how much like looser and just like jelly versus pretty solid. So there definitely is a difference. When we're making the yogurt, it's not uncommon for us to heat it up, and while it's cooling down, we'll forget about it. And it'll cool down not in substantially below the temperature we're looking for. This has gotten down to 93 degrees Fahrenheit, and so we need to heat it back up again. This is what I heated up to 165 degrees. I also did one already in the cooler that I heated up to 181 degrees. And that one I put in there once it reached the 113 temperature on the way down. I had actually preheated the cooler beforehand because I kind of recognized the time difference between these is pretty substantial. And I didn't want to have that heat up the cooler and cool itself down excessively and this not. Just with some water that was at 113 degrees when I put it in. And kind of what I'm doing this is seeing that presumably this more cooling and then raising back up is something I've observed to seems to increase the solidness of the yogurt. And I'm back up to 113. And kind of my thought on why that is because it may be evaporating more water, which is kind of where this whole experiment came from. So at 165, that's 866 grams, which is still a little bit more than what the 181 degree yogurt was at with 858 grams, both again starting at 921. Despite the additional cooling, this evaporated only 7 additional grams compared to the previous 165 degree batch, 0.8%, with the 181 degree evaporating an additional 2 grams. This again feels like too small of an amount to cause the type of difference I am seeing in the yogurt. So, I don't know, this seems like it's maybe less about like the jiggliness, but the end result is maybe a little bit better than the last time. I can't really tell, but I'm going for what I prefer in yogurt, which is really about this level. I actually don't like it a ton thicker or kind of solider than this. Thicker is, I don't actually like Greek yogurt. I find that too thick for my liking. But this is, it's an acceptable level of yogurt. It works fine, and
I can certainly work with it. It's just this is something I prefer a little bit more, and it's more less about optimizing what I like because I've figured out the way I like it. Just trying to figure out why that occurs.
I heated both of these up to 181 degrees for pasteurization, and they've now cooled back down. So what I'm going to do is, this one's actually a little bit high. I think I'm going to use this one first. That's temperature. They're very similar. They're just cooling down slightly differently, even though I heated it up the same. Is I'm going to turn on the... Okay, so that is 800 and grab a pencil, 61. And this one, so these should be pretty much identical. Is, and all the numbers, 921 to start, 15 grams of yogurt, which I've teared out. This is 866, so even with a pretty identical thing, they are a little bit different. And then, just as kind of an experiment, making sure this is still up to temperature. I'm going to add some water to this to bring it up to that 921, but I just want to make sure the water is at temperature so it's accurately matching. It's not perfect, but it's, I think, close enough. Because this should kind of get it back to what the, like if I was using milk without evaporating, just seeing if that makes a difference. Going a little bit extreme on this, or I guess really I should go up to 918 because there's 3 grams lost in transferring it. So, and I guess there's probably even more lost transferring it from the containers there, but that was 919 grams. Brought up with water. So now, next morning after day in the cooler and overnight, this is the stuff that I added the additional water to, and this is the straight yogurt. So that's pretty typical looking. And best I can tell, they seem pretty similar. Probably should have done the jiggle test. They both look the same. Maybe that's a little bit less. Maybe there's some slight flavor difference. I can never really tell with it. I did realize because I didn't mix the water in, it's possible like that somewhere there's some pocket of much less... less yogurt, or I guess not yogurt, but less thickness in here. But I didn't want to mix it in because I haven't been mixing any of these others. I've just been pouring it in and using that as the mixing. But that is a potential like issue with this. So I did another batch, and instead of heating it to like the 165 and the 181, I went higher, heating it to the 181 and this one, and 211 degrees, basically the highest I could get it on this one, just to see what sort of, if any, difference occurs when I heat it up higher. And this is a larger difference of temperature than the previous one, but I don't know if it matters. This is about the same. Both of these feel pretty solid from the start. And there is a 24 gram difference in final weight between the two of these, which is 2.6%. And that's pretty similar to, well, that's actually more than any others, which does make sense because this was a larger temperature difference and has other stuff. This is maybe a bit more solid, but it's not, I'm not certain about it. So I don't think there's much value in heating it above 181 degrees. I think I'm have some taste difference, but again, that's really hard to tell. And with these, all these different, I guess, experiments, I'm only basically doing every one of them once, which isn't great because there isn't any repeatability. But I think what I've seen is that it really is the temperature difference that is causing the differences, not the amount of water, liquid kind of concentration, which it goes a little bit against what I've previously seen, but I hadn't been doing it. I just kind of been doing it observationally, and it wasn't like I was comparing two batches against each other because I wouldn't make them at the same time. And yeah, this is kind of my experiments figuring out, which I'm glad I'm doing because, I don't know, it's something that I care maybe a little bit too much about is how yogurt is.